The B-21 Raider isn't just an upgrade, it's a complete evolution in strategic bombing. In this in-depth breakdown, we explore why the B-21 Raider outclasses the legendary B-2 Spirit in nearly every critical category. From survivability in contested airspace to long-range strike capabilities and next-generation stealth, the Raider is built for the wars of tomorrow. The Northrop Grumman B-21 Raider represents the next generation of strategic stealth bombers designed to address modern threats and global operational demands. While the B-2 Spirit revolutionized aerial stealth when it entered service in the late 1990s, the B-21 is the product of 3 decades of technological progress, lessons learned, and shifting mission priorities. The B-21 is not just an upgrade, it's a complete rethinking of how stealth aircraft should operate in a contested 21st century battle space. The B-2 Spirit was a marvel of its time, a flying wing design that could evade radar detection and strike deep into enemy territory. However, the B-2's development costs skyrocketed, its maintenance was intensive, and its operational readiness was often hampered by stealth coding issues. The B-21 addresses all of these concerns by being designed from day one with affordability, sustainability, and scalability as core pillars of its architecture.
One of the most significant advancements the B-21 brings is its open systems architecture. This modular design philosophy allows the Air Force to upgrade its systems rapidly and cost-effectively. Unlike the B-2, which requires significant redesigns to integrate new systems, the B-21 can receive software and hardware upgrades with far less disruption, ensuring it stays ahead of emerging threats. From a survivability perspective, the B-21 is engineered to operate in environments saturated with advanced air defense systems like Russia's S-400 and China's HQ-9. Its radar cross-section is even smaller than that of the B-2, thanks to more advanced stealth materials, improved shaping, and newer techniques in thermal and electronic signature reduction. In terms of mission versatility, the B-21 is designed to carry out both nuclear and conventional missions. It will eventually replace both the B-1B Lancer and B-2 Spirit, consolidating strategic bombing capabilities into a single airframe. Its adaptability to a wide range of payloads, including advanced standoff weapons, hypersonic missiles, and future technologies, makes it significantly more flexible than its predecessors. The B-21's design also anticipates the reality of multi-domain operations. In modern warfare, seamless coordination between air, land, sea, space, and cyber domains is crucial. The Raider is built to be a node in a larger combat network, capable of sharing and receiving data in real time, a capability the B-2 lacks without extensive retrofitting. Another key differentiator is autonomy and manned-unmanned teaming. While the B-21 will initially be piloted, its systems are being designed with the potential for future unmanned operations. This opens the door to remote operation, swarm coordination with drones, and AI-supported mission planning, concepts that were science fiction during the B-2's development. Maintenance and sustainability were major weaknesses of the B-2 Spirit. Each B-2 requires extensive manpower and time for stealth coding maintenance after each mission. The B-21, on the other hand, uses low observable coatings and materials that are more durable and easier to maintain, drastically improving sortie rates and reducing operational costs.
Cost efficiency was a driving factor in the B-21's development. Each B-2 Spirit cost over $2 billion in today's dollars, limiting the fleet to just 21 aircraft. The B-21 is expected to cost significantly less, around $700 million per unit, allowing the Air Force to potentially procure over 100 units. This dramatically enhances fleet resilience and global strike capability. Cybersecurity is another domain where the B-21 takes a substantial leap forward. Designed in an era of sophisticated cyber warfare, the B-21 includes built-in cybersecurity defenses to protect its mission systems, navigation, and communications. An area where the B-2, built pre-internet, is vulnerable and requires constant patching. The B-21 also features next-generation propulsion systems, likely based on modified versions of the F-135 engine family. These engines are designed for reduced infrared signature, higher fuel efficiency, and extended range. While exact details remain classified,
the B-21 is expected to offer greater unrefueled range than the B-2, allowing it to strike further with fewer logistical demands.
While the B-2 was a product of Cold War-era doctrine, designed to penetrate Soviet airspace undetected, the B-21 has been conceived for a multipolar world where near-peer competitors possess integrated air defense systems, satellite tracking, and electronic warfare capabilities. The B-21 is built to operate in this complex environment with minimal support and maximum autonomy. Aesthetically, the two aircraft look similar, but the internal structure, materials, and systems of the B-21 are completely different. Its smaller size is intentional, enabling it to operate from a wider range of airfields, including forward-deployed bases in the Pacific Theater. This improves strategic flexibility and complicates enemy targeting efforts.
Communications and battlefield integration have been core considerations in the B-21's design. Equipped with secure data links, multi-band antennas, and advanced satellite comms, the Raider will be able to function as both a strike platform and an airborne command node. This allows it to support and direct other assets mid-mission, a feature the B-2 was never intended to perform. As peer adversaries develop anti-access area denial zones, aircraft like the B-21 are essential to reasserting U.S. power projection. With its stealth, connectivity, and precision, the B-21 is uniquely suited to penetrate these environments, disable enemy defenses, and pave the way for follow-on forces. A mission the B-2 can no longer guarantee alone.
Additionally, the B-21 is being developed with logistical scalability in mind. It will be supported by a modernized training system, digital twin technology, and cloud-based maintenance analytics, allowing operators and maintainers to diagnose and resolve issues faster than ever before. This reduces downtime and maximizes combat readiness. Despite its advanced features, the B-21 is also designed for ease of production. Utilizing digital engineering from the start, the Air Force and Northrop Grumman have shortened design to prototype timeline significantly. This contrasts with the B-2, which suffered years of delays due to outdated development processes and Cold War secrecy. Importantly, the B-21 is not designed as a standalone weapon, but as part of an evolving ecosystem. It is expected to operate in synergy with loyal wingman drones, space-based assets, and next-generation fighters like the NGAD platform. This network-centric approach marks a complete shift from the independent bomber operations of the B-2 era.
Security remains tight around the B-21's full capabilities. Its first flight occurred under heavy restrictions and public images have been carefully managed. Nonetheless, defense analysts agree that the Raider is a quantum leap forward, not only in stealth but in strategic doctrine. It represents a shift towards survivability, adaptability, and integration. In summary, the B-21 Raider is not simply an improved B-2 Spirit, it is an entirely new class of strategic bomber. From its modular architecture and advanced stealth to its battlefield integration and reduced operating costs, the B-21 addresses every shortcoming of its predecessor while preparing for the conflicts of tomorrow. As the Air Force modernizes its long-range strike capabilities, the Raider stands as the cornerstone of American air power for decades to come.